を鳴らしています。実は下方の翌日は宣言が発生する日が続き、発症となっており、何者用が後ろに立つ場合があるが、毎月美容院に通うのは金がかかる。そこで自宅で簡単なセルフケアの下場をしていて、頭皮が痒くなったり、部屋かぶれに悩まされた経験はありませんか？それ、危険信号かもしれません。頭皮がダメージを受けてくれることなく、専用の刺激で悩まされては完全に死ぬと、艶もない髪が悪化しちゃいます。白髪おろしのふわふわ頭なんて、もう前に嫌ですよね。実は髪の毛は色素細胞が作り出したメラニン色素と、腰のある髪になります。つまり、この白い毛が、原因のおかげで髪の毛が染まっていくというメカニズムです。そこで専門家が推奨するのが、メラニンや髪の元となる成分のことを、特に最新の研究で分かったメラノサイトを復活させる、ピラティ SCG を摂取すれば、程よいメラノサイトを復活させ、黒く元気な髪の毛に自力で変えられるんです。ただし、ピラティ SCG といった白髪対策に役立つ成分を食事から補うのは大変。髪にいいからと、あれこれいろいろ食べたら、白髪をなくす前に太ってしまいます。そこで必要な成分だけを効率よく補えるのが、中山エミリ様が愛用しているサプリ、ミクロムラップです。このサプリは、メラノサイトを復活させるシスチンが 100mg を配合、もちろん、ケラチンもギリシルと、さらに、黒い髪を増やすのに欠かせない、人間素材、ブルチロシンや、ブリウムを増やすポリアミン、新陳代謝を促すミネラルなど、専門家監修のもとブレンドされた高品質なサプリメントなんです。医薬品レベルの製造工場で作られているから、毎日飲み続ける安全性も抜群、新井志保さんや村島正也さんといった、現役で活躍中の有名読者モデルも愛用しています。もう、調べの読んでいるのが嘘みたい。インスタでも話題沸騰、下方のことが良くなった、新彼女の実感力は強烈。何やってるの？と周りの反応がすごいです。なんて口コミでもかなり評価されているんです。背中に悩んでいるとすれば、ぜひミクロムラップを試してほしいです。今回、ここまで動画を見てくださった方限定で、通常5980円のミクロムラップを、特別に初回1980円、税込み送料無料、4人で1回しながら見せるより、安い価格でお試しできます。こちらは、毎月お届けコースですが、初回 65% オフの条件はありません。ネット通販にありがちな定期縛りはないので、いつでも解約、休止が可能、さらに30日間の現金保証もついているので、一切のリスクなくミクロムラップが試せます。もう完全に赤字覚悟の特別キャンペーンですが、使ってもらえれば絶対に分かるはずという商品の自信がひしひしと伝わってきますよね。もう一度繰り返します。多くツヤツヤの髪に必要な成分を内側からたっぷり満たしてくれる専門家監修のリクロムラップ、この動画下の商品ページからお申し込みいただいた方に限り初回1980円でお届け。キャンペーンの申し込みはこのままスマホまたは PC でお届け先情報などを入力するだけ、1分程度で簡単に完了します。クレジットカード払い以外にコンビニアド払いにも対応できるので、商品を確認してから支払うことも可能、安心して注文できると思います。この動画を見てくれているあなたは今すぐ申し込みを完了させて、一刻も早く白髪対策を始めてほしいです。こちらのキャンペーンは経営に達し次第終了とさせていただきます。ぜひ動画下の商品ページボタンをクリックしてキャンペーンを申し込みください。最後までご覧いただきありがとうございました。
風が吹くこの冬一番の優しい場所だ。彼女は道の深い眠りに誘ってくれる。ここはハワイとは違うけど、なぜ春くらいというのを言うのか。きっと小説家はもうその理由に気がついている。そう、それがこの笑顔だ。 $200 a month. It's going to be $250. And you have 10% interest on your credit card. Now, why do you borrow on instead of selling your stock? Why do you borrow on it? Which stock you sell? So, if this is successful, you're going to end up with a bigger percentage of profits. So, now it's a good business. It's like a piece of paper. It's a good knowledge. It actually tells you where the company stands, what your assets are, what your liabilities are, what your for sure which equity is. So, you take your assets. In this case, we raised $500. In exchange for $500, the person who put the money out got a third of the business. They got a two-thirds of his money. That's for starting a company. Well, that's $1,000 of goodwill for the business. $250. $200 is a liability. So we have $500 in cash on stock, $250 worth of debt, and we $250 loan. Then we have a corporation that has, you know, you'll see on the chart, shareholders have $1,500. So that's our starting point. That's key. What we need to do is start a company with $100 stand. It costs us about $300. It's called a fixed asset. Unlike a lemon or sugar or water, it's something you start a building, you buy, and build it. It grows out over time, but it's a fixed asset. And then you need some inventory. What do you need to make lemonade? Sugar, water, you need lemons, you need cups, you need supplies. So let's say you have 50 gallons of lemonade. You know, start up a business with 50 gallons, gets us about 800 cups of lemonade, and we're ready to begin. Let's take a look at the balance sheet. So now, we'll spend $500. We'll have $250 left in the bank. There are fixed assets of about $300. That's our lemonade stand. Our inventory is $200. Those are the supplies and things, the lemons that we need to make lemonade. Goodwill hasn't changed. So our total assets are $1,700. We still have $250. The person lent us the money. Surely the memory hasn't changed. So I'd make any money more done. We're taking cash. We're turning it into other assets that we're going to need to succeed in our lemonade stand business. That's assumptions about how the business is going to do over time. If we're selling 700 cups of lemonade a year, we're going to assume each cup we can sell for now. And it's going to cost us about $530 per year staff on our lemonade stand. So now it's like an income statement. The income statement talks about the profitability and what the revenues that doesn't generate, what the expenses are, what's left over. Marketing over to a company. So we're going to buy a lemonade stand. We're selling 800 cups of lemonade in our stand, charging $1 because we're generating about $800 a year in revenue. Then we're spending $200 on inventory. There's a line item here called CODS. That stands for cost of goods sold. We have depreciation because our lemonade stand has been made up over time. It grows out over 5 years, so it depreciates over 5 years. It's actually pure lemonade and collect the cash from customers. And the profit, we have a little bit, and that's earnings before interest and taxes of $10. It's kind of a pre-tax profit. For the business, we make very much money because we take that pre-tax profit of $10 compared to our revenues. It's about a 1.3% margin. That's not a particularly high profit. Now we're going to pay interest on our debts. We're going to make a loss of $15, and then we don't have any taxes, but at the end of the day, we still lose money. Should we continue to invest in this to less money the first year? It's time to do that. Well, let's think about it. Some projections about what the company's going to look like over the next several years. Let's assume that we take all the cash the business generates and we use it to buy more lemonade stands so we can grow. Let's assume we're not going to take any money out of the company. Let's not going to pay a dividend. We're going to spend money in the company and reinvest it. As we build our brand, we charge more each year, so we raise our prices about a nickel, 5 cents more for each cup of lemonade each year. And then we're assuming to sell 5% more cups per stand per year, so we've got a built-in growth assumptions. Business that we valued at $1,500 when we started, so we're putting $500 worth of